I used to make my own molds from a master mold.
And Wally Wahlstrom had no less than 700 molds he'd use as the building blocks for the vessels the Nemadji pottery would crank out. The process was pretty simple. He'd pour a slurry of clay into each mold, let it harden a bit, then release the new pot from the grip of its crucible. 21 different kinds of pots, 300 to 400 of them made in a day. There'd be some trimming and cleanup, and when the clay vessels were ready, up to 3,000 at a time were fired in Wally's kilns.
I did some of the shellacking of the inside of the pots, and I did most of the painting. In fact, all of the painting.
Dorothy still picks up an occasional paintbrush at the family ceramics business in Duluth. But the painting she did on countless pieces of Nemadji pottery wasn't with a brush, but with a deceptively simple technique.
We used a great big tub, like your grandmother used to use when she washed clothes. And then we'd fill it with water and put some vinegar in it. And then we would take Pittsburgh paint, and I'd take a little piece of wood, and then I'd go over the top of the water with it, with the different colors, and then I'd blow it, and it would go all around, and it would kind of circulate. Then when I went to actually paint the piece of pottery, I'd blow all the paint aside, put the pottery down in the water, and when it came back, I would swirl it up, and that was all. And I got so I could do it with two hands.
And the results of Dorothy's work are stunning in a most unusual way.
Well, no two pieces are alike, and you could only do 10 pieces or 12 pieces, and then you'd have to take all the old paint off and put new paint on and start over again. But they were quite unique.